this is AK. We can write AK from here as so this can be written as summation over k ak complex ak, that means summation over k mod ak square. Of course k minus infinity to infinity, this implied. So this verifies the Percival's relation for periodic signal. Now discrete Fourier series. Discrete Fourier series discrete time, discrete Fourier series. If action is a periodic signal, the period n, then this is phi xn, so the expression for all n, and lowest n is the lowest positive integer which satisfied. If n is the lowest positive integer which satisfied this relation, then this capital N is called this period. Let us have a complex exponential function xn as e raised power j omega naught n. Then this would be periodic, say it is periodic with a period capital N. Then we can form a set of complex exponential signal harmonically related, set of complex exponential function, which would be given by say phi k n e raise power j k omega naught n, because here we will see let us say period is, this period is a multiplication of 2 pi by omega naught, 2 pi by omega naught, this is integer multiple of 2 pi by omega naught, that is why it is harmonic related complex exponential. Now it has got this period, this is not distinct for all period. To see that this is distinct only in the range when k equal to 0 to n minus 1. Here on thereafter this repeats, that means you can see that phi k n is same as phi k or n, where R belongs to an integer set. You can just verify from it. Then we can represent any discrete time Fourier signal, discrete time periodic Fourier signal like this: xn summation over ak e raise power jk omega naught n summation over k, this is over one period. This is discrete time Fourier series. That means we can explain any discrete time periodic signal action, not any, a class of discrete time periodic signal action in form of this series, provided we know AK. Then how to determine AK? Determination of AK. Fourier coefficient. To determine AK, let us multiply both sides by a discrete orthogonal function. So then we get xn e raised power minus j l omega naught n, and this becomes AK e raised power j k minus L omega naught n. Now let's sum up both sides over n. Say n equal to 0 to n minus 1. Now, since AK is summed over K, is independent of N, then we can interchange the order of summation. Now this is to be summed up. This is a finite GP. This is a finite GP having n number of terms. The first term corresponds to n equal to 0. At n equal to 0, this becomes 1. So the summation of n equal to 0 n minus 1 e raised power j k minus l omega naught n, this becomes first term 1 minus what is common ratio n equal to 1. So e raised power j k minus l omega naught is the common ratio raised power n, that means capital N, upon 1 minus common ratio e raised power j k minus l omega naught. N omega naught is 2 pi. So this becomes 1 minus E j k minus L 2 pi upon 1 minus E raised power j k minus L omega naught. Now since k and L both are integers, their difference is also integer. So e raised power j, this form Euler's identity, this term e raised power minus j k minus l 2 pi. Now to solve this, let us have the average index out. So to 1 we can write e raised power 0, to this also e raised power 0. Let's take the average exponent out as one factor k minus l pi. So here we get e raised power minus j k minus l pi, and here we get e raised power j k minus l pi. Similar things over here, e raised power j k minus l omega naught, and omega naught is 2 pi by pi, then matter. omega naught by 2. Then we get here e raised power minus j k minus l omega naught by 2 minus e raised power j k minus l omega naught by 2. This from Euler's identity becomes e raised power j k minus l phi minus 2 j sin k minus l phi upon minus 2 j sin k minus l omega naught by 2. Now, since k and l both are integer, their difference is also integer, and we know any sign of any integer multiple of pi is 0. So, this becomes 0. Now, the problem is when L becomes k, then this becomes sin 0 and this is also sin 0. So, sin 0 is 0, it assumes 0 by 0 form and this remains 1, 0 by 0 form. So, how to solve this? Then we have to take the limits, this cancels. So, what we get is e raised power j k minus L pi and to this we can evaluate like this k minus l pi divided by k minus l pi multiply by k minus l pi. Look here, this cancels, so you get this only divided by sin k minus l omega naught by 2 divided by k minus l omega naught by 2. You can multiply here omega naught by 2, so that this cancels. Now, this k minus l cancels, and when l becomes k, this is sin 0 by 0 form, sin theta by theta, it becomes 1, this also becomes 1. So, when l becomes k, this is 1, and this becomes 2 pi by omega naught, which is n. So, when L is k, this summation becomes n, and when L is not equal to k, this becomes 0. So, when L becomes k, then a k turns out to be 1 by n summation over n small n over a period of n x n e raised power j 2 pi by j k omega naught n. This is the discrete Fourier coefficients. This is called analysis equation. Given a discrete time periodic signal, we can find out the Fourier coefficient, and this one is called synthesis equation. In next turn, we will take up its property. You are advised to prepare this part and try to prove this property. Next time we will be doing the property of discrete time Fourier series and try to solve some problem also. Hello, is it IIT Center of Hyderabad? Hello. Is there any student? Is there any student? Do you want to ask anything? Do you want to ask anything? Whether there are some students also? Whether there are some students also? Thank you.